Hey viewers, it's Scott, and I'm finally doing a new warlord on a longtime LAPD chief, Daryl Gates, who is considered the father of the SWAT teams. This man is one of the most important in all of police history, and I'm so pleased to do a warlord on him. If it had not been for him, we might not have any SWAT units, maybe even no way to deal with domestic terrorist threats. This man is a true hero, and he deserves to be remembered. Daryl Gates was born on August 30th, 1926, in Glendale, California, inside the region that LAPD covers. He was born and raised Mormon. Since he was born in 1926, he had to live through the Great Depression, and his father was an alcoholic known for being arrested. Gates himself was arrested in 1942 for punching a policeman for mistreating his brother over a parking issue. He apologized and all charges were lifted, luckily for him. After graduating from high school in 1944, he joined the Navy and was sent to the Pacific Theater. When he came back, he went to Pasadena City College and eventually started taking classes at USC, my favorite college. He later married Wanda Hawkins and joined the LAPD. When he joined LAPD in 1949, he started as a chaffer for the chief and ended up getting first in all of his promotional exams and advancing through the ranks until in 1978, he became 49th LAPD chief. To deal with a big possibility of a hostage situation or a terrorist attack, he was going to use a SWAT force, which at the time was just an idea. He was already under budgeted and he didn't have nearly enough officers for any bad situation, so he chose a team of brave volunteer officers, and he ended up with 15 teams of 4 men. These men were known as D Platoon in the LAPD, and were on 24-hour standby to either defend the police station in time of unrest, or infiltrate any areas barricaded off by criminals, a hostage crisis, and other high-risk situations. These officers had special training and a monthly training session to see if their skills were up to date. Once the efficiency was showed off, several other large cities quickly adopted SWAT's way of taking out armed suspects. This was very helpful during the LA riots in 1992, otherwise known as the Rodney King riots, after the results from a judge and jury was released. The reason there were riots over this was because after a high-speed pursuit, the police had used excess force on Rodney King because they had attempted to escape. This triggered one of the largest riots in U.S. history, and the riots were the second highest death toll in the U.S. of 53 and 2,000 injured. This was of utmost importance to Daryl Gates because violence was breaking out all over LA. He did his best to suppress the riots, but he didn't have enough officers. To fight this, he placed officers in strategic locations to fight off the riots. There were over 11,000 arrests during the 6-day incident. These riots were extremely dangerous in the first 2 days and lessened over the next 4 days. Overall, it caused around $1 billion worth of damage. Since California is known to be an anti-gun state, so many people didn't have any, including rioters, who attempted to buy guns and other weapons, but since California is a 10-day wait period before you can buy one, rioters attempted to raid gun stores. My dad had some friends who worked at a gun store during this time, and he said they locked up the store and laid on the roof with AR-15s equipped with sights and laser lights. The rioters would drive up, and the men who worked there would shine their laser lights at their foreheads. The rioters would slowly walk back until they got into the car and hauled ass to get out of there. Sadly, Daryl Gates resigned after the riots because he was called a racist, and people said he had no control over the police force at the time. But people mainly hated him because of his aggressiveness against crime. This was shown in his largest sweep against crime, Operation Hammer, which was trying to sweep out crime in rough areas such as South Central LA. From this operation lasting over 7 years, he had a total of over 25,000 arrests, which many people argued against, but was well needed in his pursuit for a safe Los Angeles. As I said earlier, Daryl Gates is the father of SWAT, but he also helped establish many other groups, such as the PDID, which was a spying operation that eventually went worldwide, but was sued and eventually shut down in 1983 by the Kappa Association. He also founded DARE, which was an important asset in teaching kids about how bad drugs are, which was vital to the war against drugs in the 80s. Lastly, he founded CRASH, which was an elite group of special operations in the police force that tried to fight off the new gang activity in the 80s. This was later shut down due to brutality and corruption in the ranks in 1999 in the Rampart Division. Daryl Gates was not involved with this because, as I mentioned earlier, he resigned in 1992 due to the Rodney King incident. Sadly, Daryl Gates died in Dana Point, California at the age of 83 on April 16, 2010, 2 years before Rodney King's death due to drugs. Daryl Gates will be remembered as a hero and what I think is the best chief the LAPD has ever seen. I hope you will remember him too. Anyways, viewers, this has been one of the best episodes of Bolo involving one of the best heroes, if not the best police chief that has ever lived. If you like this, please click like button, and if you didn't, don't dislike, just tell me what I did wrong in the comment section below. Anyways, viewers, it's been nice, it's been a blast, and goodbye. And don't forget to check out this video that I make in the future. Just pay attention to your subscription feeds, okay?
As a child, you would wait and watch from far away, but you always knew that you'd be the one to work while they all play. And you'd lay awake at night and scheme of all the things that you would change, but it was just a dream.